Dr. P. Nagaraj. He is currently working as assistant professor in the Department of Chemistry, Anna University, Chennai. Earlier, he worked as a scientist in charge at Spices Board of India for 5 years in research and development and also in quality control laboratory. He has finished his PhD in organic chemistry at IIT Delhi. He has also done his MSc Chemical Science at Pondicherry Central University. He has published 6 papers in international journal and also participated several international events in India and abroad. He has attended several conferences and delivered lecture as keynote speaker and also undergone 12 training programs. His area of research interests are isolation, synthesis of natural products and evaluation of their biological activities, carbohydrate-based natural product synthesis, enzyme catalyst organic synthesis, green chemistry, medicinal aspects of spices and spice products.
Welcome to UGC lecture series in polymer science. Today we are going to discuss about fiber science and rubber technology. One of the topic is natural and synthetic fibers and its properties. So today content of the talk is fabrics, fibers, yarns, natural fibers, filament, manufactured fibers and denier. So these are the topic today we are going to discuss. So fibers are considered class of evidence, have a probative values, are common trace evidence at a crime scene, can be characterized based on comparisons of both physical and chemical properties. So fiber, one of the very important component which is used in many aspects. So that we will see what are the properties and where the applications more relevant to fibers. Important compound of fibers is a fabric. Fabric is made up of fibers. Fibers are made up of twisted filaments. Types of fibers and fabrics are again we can classify into 2 class. One is a natural, another one is artificial. In case of natural fibers are origin from animals, vegetables or inorganic materials, also known as minerals. In case of artificial means which is a man-made or synthetic material which can be synthesized or created from altered natural source. So it is non-natural source we can produce in the laboratory. So these are the types of fibers. Here you can see there are 2 types, like a synthetic and a natural. A synthetic one have some examples like a rayon, nylon, acetate, acrylic, spandex and polyesters. Whereas in case of natural polymers or fibers, silk, cotton, wool, mohair and cashmere. These are all the natural fibers. Again, further classification of natural fibers are according to their origin, where the starting material which is obtained for the fibers. One is vegetables or cellulose based fibers, another one is animals or proteins, third one is minerals, that is nothing but inorganic fiber materials. Cellulose fibers, again one of the classifications, this is cellulose fibers, which in there are so many starting material or origin we can obtain the cellulose fiber, like a cotton, rayon, cellulose acetate. Cotton again vegetable fibers which is a strong and a tough, flexible, moisture absorbent, not shape retentive. That means there is no proper shape and all, but it which is have a very good toughness, flexibility, etc. In case of rayon, which is again natural fiber, chemically altered cellulose, which is very soft, lustrous and versatile compared to this one which is a quite strength wise which is lowest strength than the cotton one. And the third one is cellulose acetate, that is chemically altered to create an entirely new compound not found in nature. So this is a modified form of cellulose fibers. You can see here the picture comparison of 2 different types of fibers. Describe the differences between the cotton on the left and the rayon on the right. So this is belongs to rayon fibers, where very soft, and this is our cotton fiber. You can like a ribbon shape. This is like a thread like a shape. So protein fiber again, which is obtained from animal origin, like wool, silk, wool which is animal fiber coming most often from sheep, but maybe goat. We can also known as mohair. Rabbit, angora, camel, alpaca, llama or vicuna. So these are all the origin of getting wool fibers. In case of silk, insect fiber that is spun by silkworm to make its cocoon. the fiber reflect light and has insulating properties. So silk, which is we can also we can obtain from natural fibers, which is animal origin. Mineral fibers are also known as inorganic fibers, and there are examples given here like asbestos, a natural fiber that has been used in fire resistant substance. So asbestos is a very good fire resistance, and rock wool, a manufactured mineral fibers, and fiber glass, a manufactured inorganic fiber. So these are all the mineral fiber or inorganic fiber which can be synthesized. So in case of synthetic fiber, which is made from derivatives of petroleum, coal, and natural gases, you can look at this picture. So nylon, which is most durable of man-made fibers, extremely lightweight. So wherever you need lightweight material, you can go for nylon based fiber material. Another one is polyester, which is most widely used man-made fiber. And a third one is acrylic, provides warmth from a lightweight, soft and resilient fiber. Another one is a spandex, extreme elastic property. So this kind of cloth we can see, which is extreme elastic kind of properties. You can look at this picture, which shows that 77% which is used polyester as a synthetic fibers, whereas nylon fiber used in 12.9% and acrylic fiber 8.6 and others which is 1.5 like spandex fibers. So majority of people are used in the society is polyester, which is 77%. Man-made fibers can be used for like this making cloth and other material. Fibers derived from either natural or synthetic polymers, again regenerated fibers or synthetic fibers. Regenerated nothing but which is you can renewable like fibers. So fabric production, how fabrics are produced. Fabrics are composed of individual threads or yarns that are made of fibers and are knitted, woven, bonded, crocheted, felted, knotted or laminated. So these are all the method we can make it fabric, and most are either woven or knitted. The degree of stretch, absorbency, water repellency, softness, durability are all individual qualities of the different fabrics. So this is the properties of fibers. Some of the place we need some more absorbance, like if somewhere like a cotton which is have more absorbing tendency. So somewhere if you want to absorb more liquids or water, there you can use as a application. Similarly, which is water repellent, there are some fibers which won't absorb at all. As for example, for nylon, which won't absorb water molecule, we can use it as a umbrella making material or raincoat, something like that. Similarly, softness and durability, some of the fiber material will be long life, some of them will easily degraded. So based on that our requirement, we can choose the material where we can make the fabric. Next is a weave terminology. Again, there are four terminology like a yarn, wrap, weft, blend. Yarn, a continuous strand of fibers or filaments that may be twisted together. So that is called a yarn. A wrap is lengthwise yarn. So the another form of yarn only, which is called a wrap. Weft is crosswise yarn. So this is suppose if a length and this is cross. So this is called crosswise, which is weft, and the lengthwise, which is wrap. And another is a blend, a fabric made up of two or more different types of fibers. So that is called bend. Bend means it's a mixture of fabric materials. So wave pattern of this fabric, which is shown here, which is a plain, and this is a twill and a satin. So different, you can see the different shape, crosswise or lengthwise, which is vary from each other. Plain wave, the simplest and most common wave of pattern. Simply, it's a uniform pattern will be there. The wrap and weft yarns passes under each other alternately. Design resembles a checkboard. So this is the simplest plain wave. You can see both wrap and weft, which is present alternatively. So twill wave, again the wrap yarn is passed over 1 to 3 weft yarns before going under one, makes a diagonal wave pattern, like you can see diagonal wave pattern, and design resembles stair steps. Denim is one of the most common examples. So this is the denim, which is a common example for twill wave fabric. and a satin wave, again you can see the ununiformity of the cross line and the length line, the yarn interlacing is not uniform. So, you cannot see any uniformity in this, and it creates long floats, some of the place very long and some of the place very short. Interlacing waves passes over 4 or more yarns. Satin is the most obvious example for this kind of fabric. Knitted fabric, again which is tied each other. So, knitted means one fabric and another one fabric which is tied each other. Knitted fabrics are made by interlocking loops into a specific arrangement. So, you can see the picture, which is this black one which is interlocked with this one, similarly this one interlocked here, something like that. It may be one continuous thread or a combinations. The yarn is formed into successive rows of loops and then drawn through another series of loops to make the fabric. You can see the which is connecting as well as interlocking each other. So, such a way we can make it fabric material. Another class is polymers again. Synthetic fibers are made up of polymers. Most of the fibric material or fabric materials are polymer in nature, which are long chains of repeating chemical units. The word polymer means many, poly means many, units means mer. So, many monomer which is interlinked together to will give a polymer. Most of the fabric or fiber material which is polymer in nature. The repeating units of polymer are called monomers. So, you can see the repeating unit which can make the polymer chain. Again, polymer is by varying the chemical structure of the monomers or by varying the way they are joined together, polymers are created that have a different properties. So, you can change the monomer, you can get different polymers, or you can change the interlinking linkage. So, one monomer where it is linked. From there, you can get different polymer or different properties of polymer you can obtain changing the monomer or changing the linkage of the monomer. There you can get the different properties of polymers. As a result of these differences, they can be distinguished from one another forensically. So, that is another advantages here. We can forensic department, they can usually detect based on the interlinkage as well as different monomer, which kind of material which is used for this purpose. Filament cross section, again synthetic fibers are forced out of a nozzles when they are hot and then they are woven. So, like this the fiber material which is forced in the machine in the nozzle. So, it is a very hot, the holes of the nozzles are not necessarily round. Therefore, the fiber filament may have unique shape in cross sections. So, based on our material nozzles, the size or the shape will change, like it may be round shape or trilobal or dog bone or dumbbell shape, four lobed, octalobal, irregular, multilobed. So, these are all the different shape wherever the polymeric material you pass through the nozzles, based on the shape you can get different types of fabric or filament materials. Fibers as a stress evidence, like a primary transfer and secondary transfer, where occurs when the fibers are transferred from a fabric directly onto a victim's clothing. So, wherever the forensic department which they can use using the fabric material or fiber material, from there they can undergo the trace where it could be the committed victims. Secondary transfer occurs when the already transferred fibers on the clothing of a suspect transfer to clothing of the victims. So, such a way primary and the secondary both way they can find the trace. It is important for the reconstruction of the crime scenes. So, there the fabric material play major role. Using fibers to reconstruct crime scenes. So, you can see the conditions of the garment or fiber, what kind is it, is highly damaged or which is unaffected, something like that, based on the conditions, and the type and the composition of the fabric, what are the things is removed or which is added extra to the fiber based on that, and mobility of victim. The more movement, the more likely fibers will be transferred. So, while going, suppose this kind of fiber material which is taken, which way they are taking, that way the fibric material, based on that we can see. And another one is the length of the time between actual physical contact. So, how long the person contact the fiber material, how long it is used the fiber material, based on that also where people could identify. Likelihood of finding transferred fibers and the clothing of the suspect decreases after each day of the that passes. So, if you keep it long time, what will happen overall? The compressed fiber or something, it will come to original shape. So, you may not find evidence. So, if it is long time, if you keep it, you may not find good evidence. And testing for identification again, the fibric material, microscopic observations. Microscopy means very small, we cannot say, we are able to see our naked eye, we have to use through microscope. Burning, observations of how a fiber burns, the order, color of flames, color of smokes and the appearance of the residues. So, suppose some fiber is burned. So, using this all the technique, we can identify either fiber burns, the order, color, flame, color, smoke and appearance. So, using all the parameter, we can find out the burning and the thermal decompositions, gently heating to break down the fiber into the basic monomers. So, if you heat the molecules, polymer molecules, what will happen? The monomer will get degrade, that is the thermal decomposition or degradations. Using that also, we can identify, we can check what kind of fabric material, fiber material. And the chemical test, solubility and decompositions, again chemical you can dissolve, there are some fiber material or polymeric material can be able to dissolve in particular solvent based on that. Apart from that, decomposition, it can get like a degrade to monomer. Using those techniques, we can identify the fibric materials. Another test is the density, the mass of an object divided by the volume of the object. So, mass by volume will give density, we can find out the density of the fiber. Refractive index, measurement of the bending of light as it passes from air into solid or liquid. So, if you pass through light any fibric material, how much it is reflect, using that we can find out the refractive index of the particular fiber material. A fluorescence, which is related to light, the absorption and re-emission of light used for comparing fibers as well as parting fibers for collections. So, these are the tests, we can identify what kind of fiber material or fabric material which is present and its monomer also. Another important parameter is the dyes. A component that make up of dyes can be separated and matched to an unknown. And there are more than 7000 different dyes formulations. Chromatography is used to separate dyes for comparative analysis. The way a fabric accept a particular dye may also be used to identify and compare the samples. So, all fabric or fiber material may not accept all kind of dyes. A dye means it have some special property, like it should attach the fabric or fiber material, it should not come out easily, and the bond between the dye and the fiber material should be very strong. It should not remove by environmental condition like a light, heat, all these things. So, all fiber or fabric materials may not be suitable for all dyes. So, there are specific dyes and specific fiber material which can be used for long term effect. So, a collection of fiber evidence. So, like this we can cut some of the cloth or something, like in crime scene, we can go for this kind of testing. Bag clothing items individually in paper bags. Make sure that different items are not placed on the same surface before being bagged. So, the material should not be disturbed. Make taps, lifts of exposed skins, areas and any inanimate objects. Removed fibers should be folded into a small sheet of paper and stored in a paper bag. So, how the people are taking the crime scenes from the fabric material or fiber material for the forensic test. Fiber evidence, fiber evidence in court case can be used to connect the suspect to the victim or to the crime scene. In the case of Wayne Williams, fiber weighed heavily on the outcome of the case. Williams was convicted in 1982 based on the carpet fibers that were found in his home, in his car and on several murder victims. So, wherever you can see the fiber material may be very, very small material. If it is carries like the place, different place, we can identify this is the person from, comes from this place, and it did all the things. Problems with the fiber evidences, what are the problem if you are getting fiber as evidences? Class characteristics, mass production of goods, garments, the less common of the fiber, the more useful it is to identify a suspect. So, normally if you like a cotton, which is a simplest example or widely available example, if you use cotton as evidence, it may not be. Some rarely available or used fiber material can be used as a this kind of evidence. So, example given here, cotton is a very common, basically meaningless in forensic investigations where cotton is a evidence. Basic comparison of fiber samples, you can see there are different pictures. Microscopic comparisons of color and diameter, so color you can see all are different in color, and compare lengthwise striations, and compare cross sections of fibers, shape, fabric comparisons, weave pattern, thread count, and color separation. So, these are all way we can find out or distinguish fibers. So, today class we have seen fabrics or fiber material which is classified in two class, like natural and synthetic. In case of natural, we have seen few examples like cotton and biologically produced all the polymeric material or fiber material which can be used as a fabrics, and artificial or synthetic material we have seen some of the examples where some of the properties which is more in case of synthetic material, in case of natural occurring fabrics or fibers which have their own advantages as well as disadvantages. We have seen fabrics and fibers, yarns, natural fibers which we discussed already in detail. In case of filament also we have seen manufactured fibers, denier. So, these are all the fiber or fabric material we have discussed and their property, how it is going to used for especially forensic analysis, and based on that properties or the material, people can trace the evidence from the forensic analysis. So, questions from this topic, why are fibers valuable at crime scenes? As we already discussed how it is valuable, and how do fibers have probative values, which also we have discussed in this class. How are fabrics made? Fabrics we made, there are some methods which we already discussed, and what are the different characteristics of fibers and filaments and fabric? So, all we can do the distinguish. Are inorganic fibers natural or synthetic? So, inorganic fibers which may be some of them are natural like asbestos and all, some of them we can do the synthesis also, which is again mineral fibers or inorganic fibers, you can give some two names. So, some more questions like what is rayon? Rayon which is again naturally available polymer. How are acetate fibers made? What products are formed from the acetate fiber? So, acetate is a cellulose acetate which is one of the example, how it is made and what is the property, all these things. Why was the discovery of nylon 6 is which is important? Nylon 6 is which is synthesized long back, first fiber material. What is the important that? Which of the fabrics found in activity and would be most probative value in the investigation? So, what is important fabric or fiber material which is used for forensic studies? How are the properties of linear polymer different from cross-linked polymers? Nothing but is a fiber material. So, cross-linked which is have more strength than the linear one. Identify two types of acrylic fibers and their uses. So, within this we conclude today lectures. Thank you.